as the human population grows and the environment changes, the amount of available space for growing crops is going to decrease, and the demand for food is also going to increase. So as an attempt to provide technology for the future, we developed a combination of both the hardware platform and software platform to provide a foundation for designing and building and growing different crops and other kinds of plant materials. So two core design principles we had when designing this was it had to be both modular and scalable. The ideal target product would be a commercial piece of hardware that could be mass produced. The industry already has the standard for mounting modular computers, which is the server rack standard, 19-inch rack form factor. We've decided to take that standard and think about how could we design modular hardware for a growing situation to utilize existing technologies and innovations in that area. We can use both recycled computer hardware components, such as old data center racks, or even in some large-scale data centers, they will outdate or decommission entire shipping containers that are pre-retrofitted for servers, which means somebody could, instead of having to take that shipping crate and dispose of it, could immediately use that as is to grow crops. This machine has three chambers, two of which are designed to have identical growing conditions, so that in a production scenario, you could basically take a design or take a crop that you want to scale out and grow many of the exact same thing. The third chamber behind me is actually a larger one that is being controlled by the same electronics and software, but has different conditions. So it has different air temperatures, different hydroponic solutions, and also is different in size, so you can grow, in fact, larger size plants. In our initial MVP, we're going to be growing small leafy plants, anything from herbs to other kinds of vegetables, such as lettuce or cabbage. So all the software we're running, we're leveraging the back-end cloud of a local company called Droplet.io. I'm actually considered a co-founder of this startup. Droplet is an IoT cloud for controlling commercial devices, and basically provide a completely commercial software solution that doesn't require any custom development to operate. So leveraging that cloud for scheduling, command and control, and other kinds of, you know, API-like features, we actually adopted one of the, I guess you could say, latest and greatest wireless technologies, Bluetooth Mesh. Bluetooth Mesh is a wireless protocol that we see as the future for wireless communication. Situation where you may deploy these growing farms in a maybe like a large kind of like factory-like building. If you have Bluetooth mesh connected lighting, that those devices, the lights that have actual wireless radios on them, can provide a wireless infrastructure for our modular hardware. Effectively, the way this machine works is all the embedded microcontrollers are on a Bluetooth mesh network, and there's at least one central computer, you could say, that orchestrates all the different devices controlling the different sensors and actuators and pumps, etc. I believe we're controlling at least seven different conditions. We're measuring air temperature, we're measuring concentration of the fertilizer solution in the hydroponic bath. That's done by measuring the electrical conductivity of the water. We're also measuring the pH concentration, as well as the amount of carbon dioxide in the air. The more carbon dioxide you have, the faster the plant can grow. We're measuring the output of the light. So depending on the type of plant, you may want to increase the brightness, decrease the brightness. We're also measuring and controlling the amount of air circulation. It's actually important that you actually physically blow air on the plant, because if it doesn't have any kind of stimulation on the air, the stems may be weak and be prone to breaking. Effectively, you're creating kind of like a climate, like almost like recipe per se. The machine would run completely automated for the several weeks or months that you are growing your crop. And once you've completed that growth cycle, you're ready to harvest and enjoy your crop. After this project is over, provide all of our source code, hardware, and designs to the open source world so that they can take our project and continue to adapt and build on it.